people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. On those who live in a land of deep shadow, a light has shone. For the yoke that was weighing upon them and a burden upon their shoulders, you have broken in pieces, O God, our Redeemer. Let us pray. God of mercy, hear our prayer in this Advent season for ourselves and for our families who live with painful thoughts and memories. We ask for strength for today, courage for tomorrow, and peace for the past. We ask these things in the name of your Christ, who shares our life in joy and sorrow, death and new birth, despair and promise. Amen.
Human soul, no more.
chapter 40. Comfort, O comfort my people, says your God. To whom then will you compare me, or who is my equal, says the Holy One. Lift up your eyes on high and see who created these. He who brings out their host and numbers them, calling them all by name because he is great in strength, mighty in power. Not one is missing. Why do you say, O Jacob, and speak, O Israel, my way is hidden from the Lord, and my right is disregarded by my God? Have you not known? Have you not heard? The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He does not faint or grow weary. His understanding is unsearchable. He gives power to the faint and strengthens the powerless. Even youths will faint and be weary, and the young will fall exhausted. But those who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. The word of the Lord. I will lift up my eyes to the hills. From where is my help to come? He will not let your foot be moved, and he who watches over you will not fall asleep. The Lord himself watches over you. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The Lord shall preserve you from all evil. It is he who shall keep you safe. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. A reading from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 11. Come to me, all you that are weary and are carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. The word of the Lord. The first candle we light to remember those persons whom we have loved and lost. We pause to remember their name, their voice, their face, the memory that binds them to this season. We hold them before God, giving thanks for their lives in ours. Please take a moment to remember those who have died. I invite you to name them, aloud or in the silence of your hearts. Together we respond. Lord, he each of us takes our loved one by the hand and leads them to you, the God of love. Here we present them to you. Accept our love and thanksgiving as we entrust them to your loving care. We want our loved ones to be free at home with you. We ask that you save a place for us beside them. We ask that you fill us with motivation and energy in the days ahead when we feel like giving up. Remind us often of our true homeland when we are caught up in the desolation of the journey. Help us to find joy in the people, events, and the beauty of nature which surrounds us. Thank you for the gift each of these people has been in our lives. We want to believe that we will celebrate the treasure of love with them again, when we are all in your presence forever. May this truth sustain us in the days to come. Take our sad and aching hearts and comfort us. Comfort us, for we only feel hollowness and emptiness. God of sorrowing, draw near. Amen. The second candle we light is to redeem the pain of loss. The loss of relationships, the loss of jobs with the security they bring, the loss of health in ourselves or in family members, the loss of joy and peace in our lives from the stresses which surround us, the loss and loneliness we experience when our loved ones do not share our faith. As we gather up the pain of the past, we offer it to you, O God, asking that in our open hands you will place the gift of peace. Please take a moment to remember these losses. I invite you to name them aloud or in the silence of your hearts. Together we respond. God of mystery, we turn our hearts to you. We come before you in need of peace, grateful for the mystery of life, and ever keenly aware of your promises of guidance and protection. We want to place our trust in you, but our hearts grow fearful and anxious. We forget so easily that you will be with us in all that we experience. Teach us to be patient with the transformation of our lives and to be open to the changes which we are now going through. Amen. Thank you. third candle we light for those who experience a loss of direction in their lives. God of Exodus, you led Moses and your people through the wilderness to a new land. Hear our prayer. We want so much to have a sense of direction, to know where we are and where we ought to be headed. But the darkness and the questions stay. You ask us to be full of faith, to believe deep within you that you are our signpost, that you are our wisdom and our guide, and to trust in your presence. Your words to us are clear. Do not fear. I go before you. We respond together. God of our depths, we cry out to you to be our guide. Help us to have a strong sense of inner direction, and grant that we may have the reassurance of knowing that we are on the right path. Take our lives and use them according to your will. Take all that is lost in us and bring it home with you. Amen. God, hear our prayer. compassion and love. Listen to the prayers of these, your people. Grant to all, especially the bereaved and troubled ones this Christmas, the blessing we ask in the name of Jesus, who taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Each of us comes bearing our own hurts, our sorrows, our broken places. I invite each of you to offer your personal wound to the God who loves each of us deeply and wishes to carry our pain. God waits patiently, gently calling out, "Give me your pain, come to me, all who labor and are heavy laden, I will refresh you." I invite each of you to focus on one lit candle set before you. This candle represents the spark of hope that resides within us, even in the midst of despair. As you focus on this flickering light, be reminded that it is God who lights a candle in our darkness and holds us close until we are able to shine. Here then, I invite you to find that candle that represents your struggles, your suffering, your hurts in this season. To find it, and with light, with lighter, to light your candle. Anybody needs one. These lights in their brightness are only symbols. But as they burn and finally go out, we remember that suffering passes, though memory remains forever. As we gather this evening, we embrace and claim the darkness that is present both in the world and in our own lives. As people who are familiar with the darkness, we also know that we gather to be illumined by the light of the Christ child this Christmas season. May the Christ child born in a lowly stable, himself an outcast and marginal, bring light,